first giving honor to God who's ahead of my life. My father, Bishop Porter, my mother's sister, Melody Janae Porter, in her absence. Elder Pennant, that's my guy. That's my guy right there. I make sure my shoes shiny all the time. And I just want to thank all of you guys for the support and the love that you all always show me every time I'm here. But tonight, instead of speaking, normally I speak, you know, try to hoop until my tongue fall out or something like that. But tonight, since I've been in college, you have a lot of free time. Most of the time you use it unwisely. But I've been writing a lot. So like writing poetry here and there, just writing, keeping a journal, stuff like that. So tonight I want to share with you something that I call taking it back to the old school church. And so since I still am up here, I do want to pray. So could you all bow your heads and close your eyes? Father God, thank you for this day that you will bless us with, Lord. Thank you for letting us be able to have all these great services that we have had. Lord, I ask that you let this service be effective and efficient, Lord. And if only it touches one person's life, I ask that you let it touch that one person's life, Lord. I ask you clear our hearts, Lord, clear our minds, that the only thing that we may see is you, Lord. And again, I ask that you let this just touch one person. If that's it, just let it touch one. In the name of Jesus, we pray, amen and amen. And from this poem, I got the scripture. It's coming from 1 Peter 2 and 9. It says, but ye are a chosen, you may be seated. But you are a chosen generation, a royal priesthood,
yes,
a holy nation, a peculiar people, that ye should shew forth the praises of him who hath called you out of darkness into his marvelous light.
Yes.
We live in a world where sin is starting to become the fad. Everyone's worried about social media likes and having swag. It's always about who dresses, shouts, or sings the best. The world is so odd. I always believed that services were actually supposed to be about God. We get so caught up in being known and having titles that we forget to do the little things like telling God thank you or reading our Bibles. We need to realize it's about Him and Him only. It's not a show. That's why the world thinks that the church is simply phony. We're blessed to uncountable measures, but we act like we deserve it. But in reality, we were put here to just be good and faithful servants.
Yeah.
We need to get rooted in Him and forget all the other distractions. Show your light to the world and stop showing all your attractions. Young ladies, you must respect yourselves. Covering up doesn't make you lame. You should care about your relationship with God, and you shouldn't be ashamed. Stop worrying about being single or stuff like who loves you. And stop worrying about whether your boo loves you, as long as you know that you love him.
Watch it, Bryson.
And young men, respect these ladies. We should treat them like they're queens. We treat them like they're things instead of actual human beings. Pull your pants up. Be a gent, not a thug. You think it's cool now, but the real world will walk over you like a rug.
Wow.
But I'm talking to myself. I'm not just preaching to the choir. I ask him every day to just give me a little bit more fire so I can fight for our world. This is only the beginning. This is a war, y'all, and right now the world's winning.
Whoa.
We have to put on the breastplate of righteousness and fight for what we believe in. God will water the plant. You just have to put the seed in. And
like
someone to church, tell them God loves them. You'd be surprised how many people go days and no one hugs them. We need to spread the gospel and also spread his love. Let them know that true happiness comes from Jesus Christ, the one above. Our society is broken. We need to pick up the pieces and put them together. Time is so precious, and we won't be here forever. Tomorrow's not promised, so we must spend today like it's our last. It's going to take real effort, prayer, and sometimes even a fast. However, I'm done talking. I'm headed to my seat. I'm going out to fight, and I will not accept defeat. He loves us too much, and he gives us too much grace. Y'all can have the world. I just want to see his face. So I hope you weren't sitting here waiting on me to hoop with agonizing anticipation, because I just read you a poem about the story that I have to try to fight and get back my generation.
Oh yeah,
everybody!
Wow! Wow! You wrote that for real.
I did it.
That was good, Doc. I like that.
Come on, let's celebrate. Now, I want to say this.
Say your poem.
I can't say no poem. But I want to say this while I'm sitting there writing. It's amazing because when you look at what's in the parents and you look at what's in it, the Bible gives you know in Genesis that every seed taken after its own fitting, that if bishop
now,
is
that was good.
God has given him the pen.
That's right.
That can take him to another dimension. And it's amazing because one of the pieces that are in Brandon's book is JR, which is Justified Remix.
Yeah.
And while I was sitting there watching and listening to Bryson speak and share, I was listening to the ability of his father, but he remixed it for his generation.
Wow.
Can I just say like this to you? Can I just put it to you like this? That's why my dad would say like this. He would say, "Oh, man, stop auditioning to be a carbon copy when God has made you an original."
Wow.
So many people miss their assignment to be different, and your difference makes you unique, and your uniqueness puts you in demand. And so many of us don't understand the reason why we're not where we're supposed to be, because we're so hard up trying to be like somebody else.
That's right, right now.
When you walk in your own oil, when you walk in your own anointing, when you walk in your own sincerity, you can be the son of somebody, but you can be who God has called you to be.
Yes, sir.
You know, I got a few folk in here tonight that say, "Lord, I thank you for what you created me to be. I thank you. I don't talk like everybody else. I don't look like everybody else. My size is different. I got a different swag. But who you call me to reach? If I walk in my purpose, I'll be blessed. I may not whoop. I may not holler. I may be quiet. I may be meek. But when I'm meek, I'll be effective in the kingdom."
Go ahead, Ronell. Wow, wow, wow. That's good stuff.
So tonight, I want you to take a moment, and I want you just to honor and celebrate the gifts that God has put within the kingdom. Why don't you take a moment and just celebrate the person next to you? Why don't you celebrate the ability of someone next to you?
Young people in charge.